Trump declared a border emergency. How to look at the issue? Is it the result of the Mexican wall issue?
Well, it is directly related to the Mexican wall issue. Mm. Trump wanted to construct a wall on the US-Mexico border by spending $5.7 billion, which means $570 crore. So he wanted Congress to approve this proposal.
Yeah.
America has a very interesting democratic setup.
Mm.
In our country, Prime Minister enjoys the majority support in Parliament, whereas American President is directly elected, and he may or may not enjoy the full support of the Parliament.
Okay.
So the American Constitution gives certain powers to President and certain powers to the Parliament.
Mm.
So there is a separation of powers there also. So the Congress has to approve the has to pass the budget, and the budget has to be signed by the President of India. So what did Trump do is, I will not sign budget papers till you grant me $5.7 billion for constructing the wall.
Okay.
The Democrat-dominated lower house of America, Congress, what we call as Congress, refused to accept this thesis.
Mm.
The argument of Trump is that the illegal immigrants are coming in a big way. So he says drugs, criminals and immigrants are invading America.
Mm.
So on this is the reason which he wanted to construct the wall. But the American statistics also reveal that the number of immigrants who have come to the United States without any documentation, without proper documents or undocumented, they account for 1.3 million in 2001. So 13 lakh immigrants illegally crossed over to America. And this has come down to 40,000 in 2018. But Trump doesn't agree with these statistics. These are the American government statistics. He has his own statistics. He says 4 lakh people are coming. But even assuming it is 4 lakh, it is still far less than 2001 again. And why did these immigrants come? When you and me know how many immigrants are coming, does not America doesn't know it? America has such an intelligence establishment across the world.
Yeah.
It is the most militarily powerful nation. But American governments, successive governments, deliberately allowed people to come like that, because American immigration rules do not allow many people to come. So there are quotas, quantum. But these illegal immigrants were a source of cheap labor for American economy. If you look at supermarkets, you find these illegal immigrants, even those who come from India also, but a large number from Mexico. If you go to any shopping complexes in America, late in the evening, the cleaning operation takes place. After 9 o'clock or 10 o'clock, after shops are closed, the American, it's a practice in America that they will be clean throughout the night.
Okay.
By next day morning, it will be fresh.
Mm.
So all these people are Mexican people.
Mm.
You can find them. I have traveled America in 2013. I've seen this in New York, seen this in Dallas, seen this in Birmingham, seen this in many places.
Mm.
So this is the practice there. So all the American economy is based on the cheap labor.
Mm.
So they work in supermarkets, they work in gas stations. So American themselves segregate. Now they are only telling that these people are the problem.
Okay.
So now America's Trump says I will stop them by constructing a wall. So fine. But he wants $5.7 billion. Congress did not agree. So he did not sign the budget papers. There was shutdown in America for weeks together.
Yeah.
Shutdown means the government 8 lakh government employees did not have the work salaries also. There were voluntary organizations came forward to run community kitchens for them, especially for the low paid government workers. So that was the situation. Ultimately, a compromise was reached and the Congress sanctioned $1.35 billion. But Trump wants from somewhere between $5.7 to $8 billion. So the American Constitution has a provision. The provision is, if President declares emergency without the Congress sanction, he can divert the funds from American military budget and disaster management budget to the purpose of emergency purpose, which was claimed by the president. So this is the provision of the American Constitution. So by invoking border emergency, national emergency on the border, Trump now authorizes himself, empowers himself constitutionally to divert the funds for the construction of wall. So he has, is diverting the money from the budget meant for military construction. So for the, not tanks and all that, but for house construction and school construction for military. So he is diverting money from that to the Mexican border wall. So he wanted to construct the wall with that money. But let me tell you the hypocrisy of Trump. The first 2 years of Trump's presidency, he had a majority in both Congress and Senate, both the houses of American Parliament. But he did not go for a wall. So there were times when our software companies, IT companies were asked to pay more for H-1B visas, L-1 visas for beefing up border security on US-Mexico border. So this was a border security bill they have passed. So, but still nothing happened because that shows the lack of commitment sincerity. But why Trump is now claiming, he knows pretty well that the Congress will block it. Congress can terminate that emergency using the powers which he had, and already cases have been filed in American courts. Trump himself says, I know the case will be filed, but I win in Supreme Court, he says. We really don't know whether he'll win or not. So whether the wall comes up or not, that's the next question. But he wanted to use the issue to rouse sentiments in the white American working class, which he represents. So he wanted to create a racist divide in American society and benefit from the racist divide. So his election is a result of such a racist divide. So by creating that immigration as a major issue, so he was against black, Afro-Americans, Indian-Americans, Hispanics, Mexicans. So he was pandering to the white American racist hegemony. So now using this issue, he wanted to appeal to the conservative lobby within American society. That is precisely the politics behind it. As we are seeing in our country, there are politics in America also. So this emergency is not to save America, not to protect America. It is essentially to lobby, to appeal to the political constituency which elected a maverick called Donald Trump. So he wanted to survive on that racist divide. And he says, I have to be given Nobel Prize. Yeah, first American president who is campaigning for a Nobel Prize for himself. That too, Peace Prize, he says. He is a man who created a divide in America between the colors and white and non-white, between white American working class and the so-called illegal immigrants or immigrants. He has created such a kind of anarchy within American economy, American society and elsewhere in the world, and now he wants Nobel Prize. Maybe Nobel Committee should sit and decide a separate Nobel Prize, not just for peace, medicine, economics, but a Nobel Prize for anarchy also. If there is a Nobel Prize for anarchy, Trump will definitely get it.
Sir, is that Trump, is he planning to go to the next elections on the same America First slogan, sir?
Well, obviously, not only America First, nobody next. That will be his slogan. He represents the ultra-right. And this is the age of ultra-right rising everywhere. Not only, see the Latin America, see some of the European countries. You find a surge of ultra-right, so in including India. So a nationalist, false nationalist pride will be created. A jingoism will be created, and wanted to politically benefit from this kind of a sentiment in America. It's surprising that a multi-billionaire like Donald Trump, someone who has evaded taxes, someone who had used the American tax law loopholes to amass massive wealth, amass billions of dollars, he is now claiming to be the savior of American working class. Surprisingly, American white working class, who is certainly feeling bad because of the talent coming from outside. But American economy cannot survive without the global talent coming to America. So, well, that's the reason Donald Trump knows this very well. If $1 which America stops, America wants to save by stopping in professional from outside like India, you'll be losing $1.4. Because the competitive spirit of American economy will be lost the moment he prevents immigration. So that is the reason he is now talking about talent-based immigration. I will accept talented people, I will not accept people who have no talent. But the fundamental thing is, he wants to claim to be the only American, Now, we are seeing here also. Mm. If you question the government, you are anti-national. Mm. If you question the government, you are a Pakistani agent. Similarly, America, Donald Trump, if you question him, he is anti-American. Mm. So, he is fighting with the media, he is fighting with everyone, picking up quarrel with everyone on the earth. Mm. So, that is called the Trump's type of politics, Trump brand of politics. So, this entire emergency shutdown is a reflection of the Trump brand of politics.
Sir, I don't know if it is correct to compare both the scenarios. Trump in America and a few CMs over here like Kamal Nath, who announced that 70% of the jobs will be given to the localites only. But is it correct to...
That is there even in Telangana. Hmm. That is different. Local reservations are always there. Hmm. Even in America, before Trump also is there. Hmm. If you are an American, your admission will be much easier compared to a foreigner. Suppose if Indian, if a foreigner gets 90%, an American can get the same seat with 75%. Mm. So that is there even in America. So we have to distinguish between a legitimate regional aspirations and a parochial manifestation. Mm. What is legitimately regional? I am suppose someone in Tamil Nadu. Mm. Obviously, the local should get some, they're there in Telangana also, we have 90%. Mm. Forget about Kamal Nath.
Okay.
In Telangana, KCR ensured that more than 90% jobs are for Telangana people only. Mm. So, that is there even in Telangana. They're there everywhere. Mm. So, that cannot be considered as ultra-nationalist pride. Mm. So, as a local, we can appreciate, I'm not denying that American Trump should not protect the interest of America. But the kind of fringe he is creating, and the question of immigration is only questionable. There is nothing wrong if America wants to protect its own jobs, but same is the case with us. Mm. So America wants globalization of capital, globalization of goods, globalization of services. Why not globalization of manpower?
Yeah.
So you want American product to be sold in India. You want American banks to operate in India. Mm. You want American finance institutions to operate in India. Your insurance companies to operate in India. Mm. You don't want Indian people to work in America. Mm. So this kind of one-way globalization is questionable. Mm. So when you are really America first, let us be India first then. Mm. Let someone be European first. Mm. So that kind of a logic doesn't work. When America wants access to our economy, and it doesn't allow its economy to be accessed by India.
Yeah.
That can't be acceptable. Mm.